The stock market crashed in 1929. The United States fell into the Great Depression. Although this severe economic downturn affected the entire country, the impact on the African American community was extraordinary. Black women, who already performed some of the worst tasks and received the least pay, were often fired to make room for male workers. Some domestic workers advertised their services on the street with the hope that a family would hire them part-time. Many discouraged African American women returned home to their families in the South. Those who stayed fought back by joining the workers' movement. These efforts gave women the confidence and ambition that would pay off in the decades to come. In the First World War, after the United States entered World War II in 1941, the manufacturing companies in the North began to support the war effort. Once again, men left their jobs to fight in the war overseas. Immigration from Europe ceased, and jobs became more available to women. It was during this time that African American women began to enter the auto industry in large numbers. While in 1940, 246 African American women worked in Detroit's automobile plants, accounting for only 1% of all blacks working in the industry, between 1942 and 1944, thousands of black women began to demand jobs at Ford Motor Company. Their connection to the workers' movement in the 1930s demonstrated their willingness and ability to perform a variety of tasks. In 1944, the UAW, United Auto Workers, formed the Women's Bureau, which dedicated itself to helping black women find jobs in the automotive plants. The U.S. Employment Service also came to their aid by informing employers that more than 1,000 women in Detroit had completed vocational training courses. They argued that not using this labor force was foolish. Thus, with perseverance and the help of these groups, many African American women became employees at automobile plants. Sometimes they attained jobs as government inspectors, but usually they attained the most menial, such as janitors and matrons, but they were jobs that would help them gain experience needed for future opportunities. Unfortunately, after the war ended, many of these women, as well as their white counterparts, were let go in order to provide jobs for the men returning from the war. Black women, however, were the first to be fired. They used the experience they gained from working in the factories during the war to leverage other career opportunities. By 1960, the number of African American women working in factories doubled, and jobs in sales and clerk positions increased exponentially.